Hello and welcome to another episode of Docrafts TV. Today I'm joined by Becky James, who's going to show us some creative ways with Artiste permanent and watercolour pens. Hi Becky, welcome along.
Hi Katie.
What are we going to get up to today?
Well, today we're going to have a look at some techniques that have been used on this card using the Artiste watercolour pens and the Artiste permanent pens.
Oh, lovely.
And I'm going to start off with a neat little colour washing trick actually.
Ooh, very nice.
Okay. And so what I've got here is a little bit of cream paper from the Bellissima range. And I'm going to colour wash the edges just so that we can get a tint. You know, almost like the old-fashioned photographs where you had that colour wash tint effect. So that's what we're going to have
a go at
doing.
There's a bit of a sneak here, the sort of thing that we can see the difference between sort of before and after.
Yeah. I'm going to get the brush marker, the flexible tip end, and I'm just going to scribble on my acrylic blocks some colours. Now, I know that a lot of people out there probably already use this kind of technique with water-based markers, but I'm going to do something just a little bit different show you. So, I'm just pulling up a selection of colours. Now, I may go back and add a few more colours to this, but we'll see how we get on. Now, the next thing I need is a baby wipe, would you believe?
So any old baby wipe?
Any old baby wipe will do. Cheapest that you can find.
Okay.
No problem at all. We're just going to pull that colour up off
there. Oh, wow.
And you won't necessarily see it straight away, but it's as it dries, the colour starts to come through. And you can see there, you can really see the difference there. Another little tip just before we move on to actually doing some proper watercolouring is, if you scrape the edges of this as well, this actually becomes very porous. And if I get a brush and dampen that along the edges so that the edges become quite wet, it works quite nicely with a pink one. Get that bullet tip and you can get a nice soft sort of colour tinted.
Nice. It like sort of bleeds right into the paper.
And you can get like a nice sort of colour tinted. Again, very soft, not like as if you were adding the a dark ink directly onto there where it would all bleed through really sort of in a defined way. That actually will pull through as a very, very soft kind of edge
lovely.
To it. And
actually,
again, that is on there. You can see that around the edges there as well. Now then, I have stamped here and heat embossed the Bellissima dress here.
That's such a
lovely party dress. It's so suitable for that many occasions,
really.
And I like to start by adding the darker detail first. So I'm adding, just using the bullet tip, just a little bit of detail. And this is where my shadows are going to be. And I tend to do it in like little dots. So what I've done is I've looked at where I think the shading is going to be. So where the creases are and that sort of thing.
Like underneath the folds of the dress.
Yeah. And it's always worth having a piece of card the same as what you're using with you so you can test your colour.
Oh, that's a good idea.
So all I'm going to do is just go down from the edges. What I'm now going to start to do is to bring the darker colours in so that this top bit blends in too. So all I'm going to do, I'm doing now is, I'm just building up the depth of the colour. So just going from...
Yeah. And this paper stands up really well to the watercolouring, doesn't it?
So you can see it's starting to build up the depth of the colour.
That looks lovely.
There. What you can do is you can start to pick up some of the colour direct from the tip. It is a much deeper colour then. And then you can start to use that to build around.
That looks lovely.
Can you see where the... I'm hoping you can see. You'll be able to see it better on the picture when we've got the pictures up on the website. But it starts to then build the colour and blend the colour in that you put to start off with. So
brilliant.
That's how
perfect.
I've done the dress. Then I've added a little bit of glitter around the bottom and colour to the top as well. So those are the watercolour pens. This is the same dress but coloured in the Artiste permanent
pens.
Again, I'm going to work in a small area because one thing that's quite important with permanent pens is to blend them, it's best to work whilst they are as wet as you can get them to be. And I'm going to start off with my my sort of darker details here.
They're amazing and vibrant, aren't they?
They are so vibrant. The colour of them is so vibrant. I'm using the bullet tip. If you really want to go in fine detail, use the very fine detail tip. Or, I mean, we were talking about it earlier, great for journaling
Yeah, fantastic. I think the black one in there is my new favourite journaling pen. Yeah. I've been on every scrapbook page I've used for a little while now.
Yeah, it's fabulous. So what I've done here, again, I've started at the top and applied the darker colour. Now, you can, with permanent pens if you want to, you can start with light and apply the darker colour. But what you tend to do is, to get everything to blend, you work over the edges of the darker colour with the lighter colour and the inks blend together. I hope that makes sense. Mm-hmm. But, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get some of the pink, and I want the pink to go next. And what you do is you keep applying the ink over the edges of the red, because the red is quite hard. And then as you apply the ink over the edges, it all starts to blend. So, Katie, you probably can't see much of where the pink and the red join.
No.
All you see is the colour blending into each other to give
it
you a shade.
It definitely looks like a sort of shadow, doesn't it?
Yeah, because these pens are alcohol-based. As the alcohol goes over it, the alcohol of the previous pen, it starts to blend the two together.
Yeah.
Almost like exactly the same principle as watercolours, but with an alcohol base rather than...
So you get that vibrant finish rather than the subtle sort of pastel.
But really, really lovely to work with. Completely different look. But actually, if you tuck that dress... I'm just going to do this because I noticed this when I was putting it together. If you tuck that dress in there as well, it'll look equally beautiful.
That really works, doesn't
card.
It? Yeah, it just makes it pop out.
Yeah, so there we go.
Fantastic.
Right, I have one final...
Another one?
...little...
Wow.
...technique for you, and it includes a butterfly that's on.
Oh,
the little
glittery
butterfly.
Yeah, I wondered about him.
Now, this is actually white glitter paper from the Paper Mania glitter card stock pack. And the dies are, I love these. They're the butterflies that go
awesome.
With the stamps.
Yeah,
so
we love those.
Butterflies. And I've cut out one of the little ones. So we're going to get our... We're going to get our permanent pens. And we're going to just scribble some colour onto them.
Okay, that's looking really vibrant, Becky.
Yeah, it is looking really vibrant, isn't it, at the moment? Now, this is a very... Yes, a very old bottle of surgical spirit around in my house for a while. But what this is it's an alcohol base. And when you apply alcohol to alcohol, it actually mixes.
Now, we should
a bit
say...
like we're talking about the blending.
Because we're using surgical spirit, do be really careful. Use
Make
it in a well-ventilated
sure,
area.
Yes, definitely.
And it's not one maybe for the children to be doing. And it may be good to decant a little bit into a pot
Absolutely.
So you're not having got lots of it hanging around.
Absolutely.
Just don't take the surface off your dining table.
No, exactly.
My word.
And what you do is you work where you've scribbled it, because I literally did just scribble
That's
it.
That's really
you
good.
You start to work the colour back. But yeah, as you do it...
That's amazing.
It's incredible how the colours start to change and they bleed back into each other. And you get these sort of colour mixes and...
Lovely purple going on there now.
You have, because the colours are sort of all mixed together.
That's amazing.
Give that a little bit of a shape so you can see it. And then just pop that somewhere to let it dry, near an open window or something like that. And there you go.
That's brilliant.
So you've got little rainbow butterflies as well.
That's fantastic. That was brilliant. Thank you so much for showing us all those wonderful techniques.
Pleasure.
I can't wait to go away and have a go at really getting the most out of my pens. As I said, all the information about Becky's projects will be online at docrafts.com, all her instructions and supplies of everything she's used as well. If you've been creating, we'd really love to see what you've been up to. I know Becky's a big fan of having a look at the members gallery docrafts.com, so we might pop over and leave you a comment if you upload your project. We could also feature your project in an upcoming issue of Creativity Magazine or on a future episode of Docrafts TV. Until next time, happy crafting.